This video is made for education purpose only. So, in the previous lecture, we have studied about the enamel, but some of the students that didn't understand, so that we are returning to some part of that anomeric effect. The term anomeric effect was introduced in the year 1958, and the name comes from the term used to designate the lowest number being carbon of the pyranose, the anomeric carbon. Isomers that differ only in the configuration at the anomeric carbon are called as anomers. The anomers of D-glucopyranose are diastereomers with the beta anomer having an OH group that is placed at the equatorial position, that is pointing up, whereas the alpha anomer having that hydroxy group that is pointing towards down and placed at the axial position. So we will see this. We'll draw the structure. Okay. In this case, the hydroxy group is placed right over here, and here we have a CH2OH. The remaining hydroxy group we are not going to draw over here. So there are the two chances. The first one will say alpha anomer, and the second one, that is a beta anomer. So what is the difference between alpha anomer and beta anomer? We are going to check over here. So write first alpha anomer. As I said in the previously, this hydroxy group, which one? This hydroxy group, which is present at axial position. Which position? Axial position, whereas in beta anomer, that hydroxy group is present and at an equatorial position. Okay, remaining all things are same. This position is an equatorial position. Equatorial position. So that it is a beta anomer. So we are getting two over there. How we are getting these two? That we have to check here. Draw the open structure of the glucose. Here is carbonyl. Carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is carbon number 5. Here is the 2, 3, 4. Here we have a CH2OH. And here is the OH. The oxygen of this hydroxyl group is electronegative, so it can attach on this carbonyl carbon atom, and it gives either this compound or this compound. There are two possibilities. So how we get these two? Most important thing is that this carbon-carbon single bond, which can rotate in both directions, opposite and front and back side. So if it is like this, this oxygen comes this way, we will get axial. Suppose in place of this hydrogen, you have carbonyl and here is hydrogen, then the attack of this hydroxy, oxygen of this hydroxy will give us this compound, so that we will get two compounds from you. So this is about the anomer. Now, so what is meant by anomer? The anomer is one of the special pair of diastereomers, which is in the halogens or the ketogens, and that differ only the configuration at the C1 and the C2 position. If it is a halogens, the configuration difference at the C1 position. Where is the difference? At the C1 position. And if it is a ketogen, the configuration is different at C2 position. So you can ask me this, how it is different in a aldogen at the C position, and why it is different in a ketogen at the C2 position. So we know that D-glucose
glucose and the D-fructose. Okay, in D-fructose, carbonyl carbon is present at position 1, whereas carbonyl carbon in ketogenic at fructose, which is present at 2 position. So the difference of allomers which occur in the C1 position in the aldolase, whereas in ketogenesis at the C2 position. Now the question arises, the percentage of alpha anomer and the beta anomer present in the D-glucose. So what is the percentage of alpha anomer and the beta anomer present in the normally occurring or naturally occurring D-glucose? So there are the two possibilities, or we can say there are three possibilities to get that possibilities to occur. The first one is that we will get around 63% of beta anomer is there, whereas only 1% of D-glucose is present in a linear form. And the third one, that is 36% of alpha anomer is present. So alpha anomer is 36% plus beta anomer is 67% and remaining, one moment, 36, 67, and 1% is linear glucose. 1%. Okay, there may be some difference. Okay, don't get confused. But major anomer is a beta and the minor anomer is an alpha. So how we get that, we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss about the mutar rotation. What is meant by mutar rotation? The alpha and beta anomers of carbohydrate are typically stable solid. So what does it mean? Alpha anomer as well as beta anomer are stable and solid. Okay, and in solution, what we have to do? In solution, a single molecule can interchangeable between straight and ring form, different ring sizes, and alpha and beta anomer isomers, anomeric isomer. And the process is a dynamic process, and due to reversibility of the reaction, all isomers can potentially exist in solution, energy stability of different forms. So what are the criteria or characteristics for mutar rotation? Already we have discussed in a short mutar rotation. It is for mutar rotation, the important condition, there are three important conditions we have discussed already earlier, but again I am discussing over here. The first condition was is compound should be optically active. First condition. Second condition, crystalline solid. Compound should be crystalline solid. And the third condition, it should be a solution. These are the three conditions are required to determine the mutar rotation. So mutar rotation mean what? Mutar rotation is nothing but the interconversion of an alpha anomer and the beta anomers. So how we can say that interconversion of alpha anomer and the beta anomer get occur? So the interconversion, which I have said now, the beta anomer is a more, beta anomer is a 67%, alpha anomer is 36%, and its rotation is a very important. So this is not 67, it is a 64%. Okay, so what does it mean
the interconversion of beta anomer to the alpha anomer or vice versa. That is called as meta rotation to achieve the equilibrium. What is important? Important is to achieve the equilibrium. So how we can achieve the equilibrium, that we will discuss more here. Okay. So write the structure of the anomer. Okay. This is the beta anomer. So when we try to getting convert into the alpha anomer. So the process occurs, see, this bond is getting broken over here and getting aldehyde, or we can say aldose. Okay, then this is the rearranging. This is the rearranged product. Rearranged. Then what we get at the end? Alpha. If you see, the specific rotation of beta anomer is 18.7 degree. The specific rotation is denoted by alpha in the square bracket at 20 degree. Okay, it is denoted by alpha and its value is 18.7. So, in case of alpha anomer, the specific rotation is how much? It is 102 degrees, 112 degrees. So when it comes in the equilibrium, what happens? This beta anomer and this alpha anomer, when comes in the solution in the water, what it indicates? It comes to the equilibrium and it shows the specific rotation 52.5. So effect of these two forms can be synthesized and isolated as pure compounds. The alpha anomer of D glucose has a specific rotation of 112 degrees in water. The beta anomer of D glucose has a specific rotation of 19 degrees, that is 18.7, it is assumed to be 19 degrees actually, but rounding up to 19. Okay, here the interesting thing is that when other anomer is dissolved in water, the value of the specific rotation changes over time into reaching 52.5 degrees. The specific rotation of alpha D glucopyranose decreases from, so alpha D glucopyranose is 112 degrees, so it decreases to 52.5 degrees. In the other case, means in case of beta anomer, the specific rotation is 19 degrees, that increases to the 52.5 degrees. The similar type of principle is applied in case of alpha D mannopyranose and beta D mannopyranose. So the similar way we can study the muta rotation of ribose, D ribose. We must know the structure of D ribose. What is the structure? How we can draw the structure of D ribose? D ribose is, ribose is a 5-membered sugar, 5-carbon sugar, that is the pentose, which is having the 5 carbon. One carbon is a CHO, then carbon number 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5 is having CH2OH. And all carbons are having, each carbon is having one hydroxy group, and all the hydroxy group are present on the right hand side. Okay. When it cyclizes cyclic sugar of this, what happens? There are two possibilities. What are the two possibilities? You should get alpha anomer or beta anomer. These are the two possibilities. Okay. So attack of this oxygen from this hydroxy on this carbonyl carbon, it can be occurred in the two ways, and that determines which one we will get, alpha anomer or the beta anomer.
And in case of, and whatever we get, that is a furanol. Okay, that we will get a furanol. And alpha furanol is a 7.4% and beta furanol is a, alpha furanol is a 7% and beta furanol is a 13%. Okay, that is about the cyclic sugar. And in case of pyranol, there is a chance to get a pyranol. How will you get that pyranol? Because of the cyclization of this CH2O, and that is pyranose is how much? It is a 20% alpha pyranose and 20% alpha, and the beta is 60%, around 60%. So this is about mutual rotation, and we stop here, and this video is prepared for education purpose only as per the syllabus of SPPU Pune. Thank you for watching this video.